We are here today with Dr. Aaron Fleischauer, who is a captain in the United States Public Health Service. Welcome.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you. Why don't you tell us a little bit about where you're working now?
Sure. Well, I've been with CDC for over 12 years now, and now for the last, it's been about 6 years, I've been assigned to the North Carolina Division of Public Health as a Career Epidemiology Field Officer.
But you got your start here as an EIS officer,
right? Yeah.
So what made you decide to go into EIS, which is also known as the Epidemic Intelligence Service?
Right. Yeah, well, even in graduate school, I knew about EIS. There had been graduates from UNC Chapel Hill who had gone into the program. I was always fascinated with CDC. So I knew from early on I wanted to do EIS. Then when I sent in my application, I had my first interview with Dr. Thacker, and I think I exploded with excitement in his office because he kept laughing at me. So I had known for a long time I wanted to do EIS.
So this is sort of the fulfillment of a long-term dream for
exactly,
you.
Exactly, yeah.
Now, when you came to CDC and you became an EIS officer, what program did you work with?
Well, I had interviewed with a lot of programs, as we do during the match process, and I was selected with the Bioterrorism Preparedness and Response Program, which I don't think exists in its current capacity anymore. But that program was essentially designed to do outbreak response, do consultations on bioterrorism preparedness, syndromic surveillance. So I was with them for 2 years.
So if you think back on that 2 years you spent in that program, what were some of the most memorable outbreaks you worked on?
Right. Well, that was an exciting time. It was 2002 to 2004. So within a few weeks, I deployed for West Nile virus. And then a few months later, it was monkeypox outbreak. A few months after that, it was SARS. And then about 6 months after that, it was avian influenza. So it was an exciting 2 years, yeah.
We worked together on at least two of those responses, monkeypox and SARS. And we worked in a part of CDC called the EOC. Do a lot of EIS officers get to work there?
Well, historically, no. But now, absolutely. The EOC has always developed itself to be the support program for responses. So a lot of EIS officers filter through there and conduct their responses through the EOC. It's an exciting opportunity to see that excitement of a response and what's all involved in that.
And we should say EOC stands for Emergency Operations Center,
right,
and it's
right.
Really the hub of current outbreaks, and it's going on right now with the Ebola response.
Yeah, that's right.
How did EIS influence your future career path?
Yeah. Well, I think EIS taught me how to be an applied epidemiologist. I think coming out of graduate school, getting your PhD in epidemiology, you think you know epidemiology. You know how to be an academic epidemiologist. When you do EIS, you learn applied epi, and it's almost a different field all to itself. You learn how to interact in the field with patients, with healthcare providers, with local health departments, how to collect that data yourself locally and use it to inform an immediate decision. And that's not something they can teach you in graduate school.
So really, hands in the field, boots on the ground,
exactly.
Learning as you go.
Shoe leather.
Is absolutely what I loved about EIS myself. Now, EIS has changed a bit since we did it way back when. What do you think the future holds for the EIS program?
Well, I think it should always hold on to its fundamentals of shoe leather. Teach people what is the transition between academic epidemiology and field epidemiology. I think once they learn those basic skills, then they can do any field they want at CDC. Now, I think in the future, it involves more technology. Public mm-hmm. health informatics is going to be huge. Social networks and social media will be huge. So I think you'll find technology emerging into the EIS fellowship. But I think fundamentally, once you learn those basic field epidemiology skills, it should hold on to that paradigm.
So one final question for you. It's been lovely talking to you, by the way. Do you have any words of advice for people who think they might like to apply to the EIS program?
Right. If you think you're interested in public health, epidemiology, if you think you want to change behaviors, you want to change people, you want to make them healthier and have an immediate impact, I think EIS is an excellent fellowship opportunity for you. I've done many outbreak responses. I've worked on programs that I really feel that I made an immediate impact. Almost if you think of Jon Snow removing the pump handle and ending a cholera outbreak. Sometimes I feel we have that opportunity, and that is a tremendously rewarding experience.
Well, that's a great note to end on. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you for having me.
It's been a pleasure talking to you.
Thanks, Jenny.
Thanks.
Bye-bye.
Bye.